We would like to welcome you to African Liberation Day. This is the 32nd annual African Liberation Day commemoration and celebration in line with the struggle of Pan-Africanism. We would like to give some of the historical analysis of African Liberation Day. We say that a great old man by the name of Dr. Osasefo Kwame Nkrumah, who became the first president of Ghana in 1957 by overthrowing the British colonial power, saw the need with other Africans to organize African Freedom Day on April 15, 1957. And Africans celebrate African Freedom Day up to 1963. But the organization of the African Unity changed African Freedom Day to African Liberation Day and changed from April to May 25th. And Africans throughout the world have been celebrating and organizing African Liberation Day ever since. We would like to say that our organization, our African People Revolutionary Party, have dedicated itself to build African Liberation Day as a permanent institution to use towards the struggle of African peoples throughout the world. We can stand here proud today and say that our organization, along with other coalitions, have organized 12 African Liberation Days today. So we do not sit here alone in honor of African Liberation Day.
Right.
That we have 12 other African Liberation Days that's going on throughout the world. We would like to say that we have African Liberation Day going on in Washington, D.C. We have African Liberation Days going on in Cincinnati, Ohio, and London, England, Los Angeles, and Sacramento, California, and Dallas, Texas, St. Thomas, the Virgin Isles, New York City, Paris, France, Born West Germany, in Toronto, Canada, and of course here in Jackson, Mississippi.
All right.
If I can get my mic here straight, maybe I'll go over my presentation.
All right.
I only have a brief time, so I will try to go through the presentation. Some of the things that our organization wanted to express and imbue the mass of African people with. We want to deal with the theme of African Liberation Day, which is 90 years of organizing Pan-Africanism. And we've been struggling 90 years to build Pan-Africanism. We said that Pan-Africanism has always showed that Africans from different parts of the world come in to put their energy forward to organize Pan-Africanism.
Okay.
Africans from the West Indies, African born here in the U.S., Africans born in the Caribbean, African born in Britain, Africans born in Africa. We said from 1900 up to 1945, Africans struggled to build Pan-Africanism. We said that Pan-Africanism was first put in world dictionaries in 1900, the turn of the centuries. We said that all of the Pan-Africanist Congress was held, the most significant was the 5th Pan-Africanist Congress. We said that this Pan-African Congress made such a great discipline and a different aspirations of Africa because of the ones who attended African Liberation Day. We said that the workers attended African Liberation Day. Students attended African Liberation Day. Trade unionists attended African Liberation Day. We said that every second of our people attended African Liberation Day in 1945. And today, we see that this Pan-African struggle is continuing, and will continue to continue through the struggle of African people. First of all, we want to try to come to deal with this question of ideology. We said if one don't understand their identity as an African and don't see that Africa should be the most important thing in one life, then they have a foreign ideology.
Right.
We want to make our party line clear. We want to make our party objectives clear.
Yeah.
We want the masses of you here to go out into the neighborhoods, into the communities, where it is internal or external. There's the same thing as in the U.S. or there in Africa or the Caribbean or wherever. We want to say that ideology is the most important thing to a people. We say ideology must be the weapon of the oppressed masses of our people.
Right.
We said without ideology, then we are in a state of confusion. We said that ideology must be a concept of analyzing African history. We said this ideology must be a concept that brings forth a guideline to analyze African history. That we should rely upon African history and analyzing African history. We have heard many things here said today. Some of the things you might hear me repeat as an echo, and some of the things you hear I say today will be new. But we want sure to deal with this question of ideology. We said that the capitalist system, who have continued to brainwash our people for over 500 years, a child slavery, and economic slavery, and our people still are confused about who are the enemy of our people. We said because our people lack political education. We said political education will enhance the ideological aspiration of our people from a national class perspective. We said that ideology must be the foremost important thing to a revolutionary who come to make war, who come to destroy the enemy of the African masses, in particular, and the enemies of the world in general. We say that ideology asks our people to read about ourselves. We said if one don't understand the ideology of Africa, then one is expressing somebody else's ideology. We're saying that ideology must be the concept that Africa is our homeland. The ideology says that Africa is the only just claimed land that we as an African can lay just claim to.
Right.
We say ideology teaches you who you are and the contribution that we have made as Africans throughout the history of Africa. And as Malcolm said, you show me one of these who hate Africa, I'll show you one who knows nothing about Africa. Because
right.
When you see African brothers and sisters saying that they are not Africans because they have no understanding of Africa's great civilization and what it has gained to world civilization. So we said we need to read more. We need to see political education as the modern weapon of all revolutionaries today. And we said ideology plays the far more importance of this struggle towards liberation, unification in Africa under scientific socialism. We say that ideology must coexist with the identity and the culture of the people. Because if your ideology is not in line with your identity and with your culture, then you have a foreign ideology. So one of the things that we certainly need to do is discuss Africa. We say that we have been struggling a long time over the question of Africa. You are African. Africa is our homeland. Africa we need to fight for. Africa we need to liberate. So we say Africa must be one of the four most important things to us in education. explain to our people about Africa. We have to look at our history as a people and analyze it. We must look at the collective struggle of our people. The collective struggle of our people versus the individual struggle of our people. We say individual effort is good, but collective struggle is the best struggle.
Right.
So we said organization shows itself as a collective struggle.
Okay.
We said that the Pan-Africanism and the Pan-Africanists throughout the world must come to show themselves as a collective struggle, as a collective front, struggling to liberate and free Africa and African people scattered throughout the world. We want to come to also deal with this question of organization versus mobilization.
Right.
We say organization is long range. Mobilization is short range. We look at the movements in the 60s, and we say that those movements were mobilization. They were not organization, they were mobilization. We said mobilization is on to bring forth reform movements. Reform today and be back in the same situation tomorrow. Whereas organization is permanent and must be made permanent in our everyday life to understand that the collective is more important than the individual, that the whole is more important than the part. And we said that organization must be something permanent. As our party always stresses, join some organization working for the masses of the people. Because just to say I'm African, just to know I came from Africa, do not mean that I understand the proper responsibility that I have to Africa and other Africans. And this is the fundamental difference between those who know they're Africans, know they is from the continent of Africa, but don't want to give up any work, don't want to give up any struggle for Africa and Africans.
Right.
So we said organization must be primary in our lives. Kwame Nkrumah says, without organization, we cannot do anything. Sixth Red says, to start a process and to stop it soon afterwards is dangerous.
Right.
It will not start the process.
Right.
So we said the organization must be the primary focus in our life as African people. This focus must be work. This focus must be work. We said we don't have to ask the brother over there if he's a member of the Nation of Islam or he's a Muslim. We can tell that by his work. We don't have to ask the brother who was at the symposium last night if he's a Christian. We can see that by his work. One can come to say, I'm a revolutionary, but does nothing for the people, but says, I'm a revolutionary. So we say we must take this collective energy and put it into an organized process in order to liberate and fight for the independence of Africa, for the liberation of Africa. The organization is everything to us. And without organization, we cannot do anything. We want to deal with also looking at our coalition and our brothers and sisters organizations. We want to look at our alliances that we're in line with and give support to, who's struggling against the same capitalist, imperialist, Zionist, racist, apartheid regime, and other parts of the world. As Picasso said, that you can turn on your television set today and see the Zionist Israel movement of Zionism to destroy the Palestinian people. We see the youth of the Palestinians in the street fighting these Zionist dogs with bricks and balls.
Yeah.
And our youth here don't understand that they're Africans and we want the capitalist system, the educational system of America, to educate our people about ourselves. These are the same dogs who came to keep our history from us.
Yeah.
So we want to look at the struggle of the Palestinian people who struggle to regain their homeland, who understand that Palestine is their homeland.
Right.
And they can show just claim, historical just claim to this homeland of Palestine. I'm glad Brother Mohammed said that Judaism and Zionism is totally different.
Right.
We know that Africa and Egypt brought forth Judaism into the world. That anybody can be a Jew, just go join a synagogue. We say that Zionism was a movement created for Europeans to have a circle on his territory in Palestine. Given to them by the United Nations in 1948. And who have continued to take land from the Palestinian people and disperse them throughout Africa and other parts of the world. They call these freedom fighters, these revolutionaries of Palestine, terrorists. And if they are terrorists, I hope they keep on terrorizing Israel.
Right. Yeah.
We said Zionism as a movement must be crushed.
Right.
Zionism is not only in Palestine. The Zionists have stole throughout the United States, who get money, sending it to Israel, to build Israel. To build Israel in the name of self-colonialism. So we're saying to you, these same Zionist dogs who are in Israel is right here in the U.S.
Right.
And we said, we must always give support to the PLO and the Palestinians in their struggle for democracy, freedom, and liberation of their homeland. We said, when we come to talk about Zionism, it's hard to talk about Zionism without talking about the apartheid regime in Tanzania, South Africa. It's hard to talk about the apartheid in Tanzania, South Africa, without talking about racism. It's hard to talk about racism without talking about imperialism. See, it's hard to talk about imperialism without bringing up neocolonialism. These are systems, systems of government who are oppressing African people and other people throughout the world. Some things that I think we need to understand. I understand that the Europeans came to Africa, kidnapped us from Africa, brought us here to the Western Hemisphere and throughout the diaspora. But at the same time, we have to understand that this was a system, not a people. So we have had many attacks today, many people saying that we're struggling for humanity of the world upon one hand. But on the other hand, we're struggling against white people. We said we look at Northern Ireland, where they have been struggling against British imperialism for over 800 years. We said we must come support all these who are struggling for the humanity of the world.
Yeah.
This humanity must come to show itself as true democracy. As true democracy. Not sham democracy. Not bourgeois democracy. But true democracy. We said before one can conclude or analyze something, then it must be two sides of it. We know that this capitalist system of America has never taught us nothing about ourselves. Never. and never will. So we said, in true democracy, one must come to understand both sides of it. In order for one to be able to make a critical and correct analysis of the situation that we find ourselves in today. They say I have to go, but a couple of more points I surely have to make. I hope y'all will stay with us. I don't know, at the same time that we have to be at the par or not be at the par. In the end, we just have to get put out in the land. We want to say that our organization is a socialist organization. We believe in scientific socialism. We believe that all of Africa and its resources belong to all Africans throughout the world. We said that the Africans must come to see themselves as an integral part in building socialism in Africa. We said socialism have never failed the people, the people have always come to fail socialism. We said our people know more, less about socialism. And unless you know about something, unless you can come to criticize it, analyze it, and put it in the proper perspective. So we said, please read more about socialism. Find out more about socialism. Find out more about true democracy versus sham democracy. We want to also deal with, what is the APRP? We must deal with this. We say the All African People's Revolutionary Party is a mass, independent, socialist, revolutionary, political party. Mass, because we say it takes a mass of our people to come to liberate Africans and Africans throughout the world. We say that we are an independent party because we will not accept no money or any influence or no help from those who are against our people, who come to dictate what we are to say or not to say in line with the struggle of our people. We say we must be independent. We say we must be a socialist because all of Africa belongs to all Africans and all the resources inside of Africa belong to all Africans and must be used and benefit by all Africans. We say that we are a revolutionary party. Revolution is based on land. A land one can come and lay just claim to. Not land that one have been usurping for 500 years, 600 years, 1,000 years to lay just claim to. Because history will come and eat you up. So we say revolution is based upon land. The landless against the landlord. So we said we must come to liberate Africa. And we can do it through nonviolence, no problem. If we have to throw hanging knives, no problem. We said we are a political party. So our party must be a political party. And Kuma teaches us first sit down political kingdom. And we'll control our political life. Then we'll control our economic, our culture, our social, our religious life. It's impossible. So we said first, let's get political mature. Let's become politically educated. Let's understand the system for having a political, mad, revolutionary, socialist party. We'd like to also say in closing, our organization are organizing work study circles. Our organization at this time concentrates on the college campus. But we'd like to say that our party is an All African People Revolutionary Party. And that we ask you to come and join our organization. And if you will not join our organization, join the Nation of Islam. Join the New African People Organization. Join some organization that is struggling and working for the masses of African people. We would like to thank you for coming to the 32nd anniversary of African Liberation Day. We would like to say whatever you heard from the speakers today, will you take it back and share it with those who were not able to come? And we always said, forward with the revolution. Thank you.
Forward with the revolution!